trying, Ivan.
No.
Should we save this for posterity? So Anthony's selling his Oculus Rift with Leap Motion?
Yeah.
On eBay, do you have the URL you want to put up?
No, not on eBay yet. It's $350 to $450,
I think. So $350 to $450. So, are you now tweeting my advert for his Oculus Rift? Right. So you have to warn it this way. I have ruined the Raspberry Jab in that I brought an actual PC with me down there somewhere. And on one of those, which is an Oculus Rift. Has everybody had a play with it?
Yeah.
Do people want to play with it?
Yeah.
They'll be hanging around. So, what you've got in this thing, which you possibly can't see, is two screens. And what it does is it feeds these two images to each of your eyes. You get depth perception from it. So as you look around, it changes perspective, and it looks like you're in 3D, which is kind of cool. So those ones are out of production now, because they were part of the dev kit. The new ones are out end of this year, beginning of next year. Runs off HDMI, you need something that can, ideally see that's fairly quick to actually give you a relatively high frame rate, so you're talking above 60 frames per second. To actually run that and to look okay. Otherwise you get kind of jitter as you move your head around, so that's going to get relatively quick. Are you going to talk about the strange thing you wanted to do, or do you want me to do it? No. The camera that I'm being filmed with is a 3D camera. So it's got two lenses on it, and it allows you to record in 3D. The idea, which was a stupid conversation before we started the jam, was to strap the camera on your head with the Oculus Rift, and then basically feed the image from the camera into the Oculus Rift and wander around. I'm assuming we'd also have to strap a PC to your back to make it work.
Or a very long cable.
Or a very long cable, that's true. Very long cable. There were some experiments that I'm pretty sure it was just a cruel scientist did, where he gave people glasses that would flip images upside down. So you put on the glasses, everything's flipped upside down, you wear them all the time, and your brain adapts. And you see everything normally. And then after a little while, he takes the glasses off you, and everything's flipped upside down again. And after a little while, you adapt. So Anthony, who doesn't want to talk about it, had the idea, I think it was you that had the idea, was with the Oculus Rift, you could switch eyes. So you could take the 3D from the, from the left eye, from the 3D camera, and feed it into your right eye to see if you can completely and utterly destroy your depth perception. His Oculus Rift behind. Which is a completely cool and evil scientist type of thing to do. Which I think you should do before.
I'm actually doing an Android on cardboard.
Oh, with Google? Okay. Yeah, that could work.
Yeah.
We could probably do the exact effects. You don't need the cardboard, which is RAMs with the 3D camera. You just need two USB webcams.
Yeah, or use an HTC up there. What are the HTC phones up there? My HTC phone's got a depth camera in it.
Oh, right, so you're good. Anyway. And then flip the images in that.
Yeah.
That's actually probably a much better solution than having a PC strapped to your back.
Yeah,
it is. Why we came up with this idea, right? Why you killed that thing, I'm playing with you. I have no idea. So, anybody that wants to play, there's a roller coaster for the last couple of minutes. Sit down, don't go too far away from the PC, because the cable's only so long. And it can make you feel queasy, which is the other thing. After that, there's some games on there as well. So it isn't just a roller coaster. You can play games on it. I have no idea what the games are, because I haven't looked, and I didn't set it up. So I'll quit the roller coaster for a little while and put some games up for people who haven't played the games. After everybody that wants to go has had a go. Was that enough?